Hi, welcome at the ISU Center of Excellence Keep Training Series. My name is Simon Kuipers. I'm the head coach of TELF Heerenveen Center of Excellence. And today we're going to do an online training with you guys. And it's called Downtime and Skating Imitations. But before we're going to start, I would like to introduce you to Manon, my colleague.
Hello everyone. So as Simon said, my name is Manon, and last year I am one of the coaches at Road to Ice Week. And today we are at a special typical Dutch place. So as you can see here behind me, there is an old windmill. So there is no better place to train today. So I say, let's go.
Let's go.
But first, if you have any questions for us, please use the YouTube live chat and then we can answer your questions. You can see we use a speed ladder today, but if you're not having that at your home, you can make it by yourself to use on chalk. Okay, let's start with the first exercise. That's called the high knee. Make sure that you do every exercise 3 times. Okay, exercise 2 is the heel kick. Make sure that you place your feet in the square. Okay, exercise number 3, they are side steps around the speed ladder. Okay, with this exercise, make sure that you will be a little bit low. Exercise number 4 is a little bit stretch for the hips. It's called figure 4. Make sure that you will be straight and looking forward. And keep staying balanced.
Thank you.
Exercise number 5, they are crossing side steps, also in the speed ladder. And make also sure that you place your feet in the square. And speed it a little bit up. Drill number 6. Exercise number 7, also in the ladder, and it's some stretch for your hips to open it up. Stay on one leg and push yourself up. Keep your balance for a few seconds. Exercise number 8, it will keep your heartbeat a little bit up. It's called a jumping jack, also in the ladder. And if it's going well, you can speed yourself a little bit up. Exercise number 9, jump in around the speed ladder. First out, in, out, in, out. Okay, we are almost at the end of the warm-up, but I have only one exercise for you left. This is a two-touch to give your hamstring a little bit stretch. Take a look.
Okay, Manon, thank you for the warm-up. I'm warm. I hope you guys are warm as well. Let's go and start the real training. We finished the warm-up with the ladder, and now we're going to do some core activation to make sure everything is warmed up before we really start the training. Manon is doing the bear walk now. So small steps forward with your hands and with your feet, and they move at the same time. And backwards. Keep it tight, try not to move in your hips, keep everything straight. small steps forward and small steps back. Keep it tight. Okay. And the next exercise we're going to do is the mountain climber. You can do it quick, which I will do, or Manon, you can do it a bit slow, so do it on your own pace. Make sure you put your knee forward and you jump forward, you jump forward. And if you find your rhythm, push it, push it, push it. Bring your knees in, keep your back flat and keep pushing. 20 times. And a break. The next exercise we do is we're going to make a plank on your elbows and on your toes. If this is too heavy for you, you can also do it on your knees, like a Manon is doing. And hold this for 20 seconds. And after 20 seconds, you turn to the side. Make sure you keep your body straight from your toes to your head. One line. Hold this for 20 seconds. And after 20 seconds, you turn to the other side. And Manon is doing it on the knees. And if you're stronger, you can do it on your elbow. And try to hold 20 seconds. Okay. Next one we're gonna do is a dynamic plank. So we start on our hands, go stand on your toes, one line, and go down to your elbows, holding your elbows, go back on your hands, on your elbows, and back on your hands. And keep one line. Keep everything tight. And up again. And Manon is doing one on her knees. If it's too heavy on your toes, you can do it on your knees. Okay. The next exercise we're going to do is a crunch. Find something in your home. I have a big book, so it's pretty heavy. And we do this 10 times. Make sure you go down, all the way down, and up, and down. Stretch. Keep your arms in one line. Okay. I'm ready, Manon. How are you?
Yeah, me too.
Yeah?
It was a heavy core exercise.
I'm totally warm and I really look forward to the next one.
Yes. Okay, we are now at the main part of this training. We are starting with some skating imitations. The goal of those exercises is to stay low, in control and move slowly. Okay, we will start the first exercise of this part. That's called the skating shuffle. It's very important by this exercise that you stay in very low and keep your balance. So you can see Simon shuffled from the left to the right, and every time he stands on one foot, his balance is in the middle of the feet. You can make one straight line from the shoulder to the knee above the toe. And stay low. Keep going for a few seconds. And stay in balance and keep the control. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and going up.
Two.
So the next exercise we're going to do, first we hit the shuffle, and now we're going to do a small step. So we go down into the skating position, start on one leg and just a small step to the side, and you bring your body weight all the way to the right side and to the left side. And while you do this, you stay as low as possible. You don't have to go fast, just keep control and really feel you're standing on top of your legs. Stay low. Nice. Bring your shoulders all the way over. One line from nose and knee and toe. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Yep.
Okay guys, the next exercise have to focus on one leg movement. This is very important in skating. So listen up. Simon, going down, move to the other side. Going fully up, keep in balance and move to the other side. So as you can see, he always stay low if he move from the left to the right. But if he's going up, he must stay in control with his upper body and have to wait at the middle of the foot. You can use your leg to stay more in balance, but keep in mind it's very important that you only move your body weight on one leg. Okay. Keep going, it's looking good. Okay.
Okay, for the next exercise, we have two versions. One is a bit more for the beginners, the other one is a bit more for advanced. We start with the one for the beginners, but everybody can join this one. So Manon, if you can go into skating position, jump away, small steps, and see that your leg is just a little bit behind your other leg. But keep your balance, keep your balance. Try to go down on your knee when you're low. go into that skating position. You feel it probably burning, it doesn't matter. You get better doing this. Good job. Five more. Three, two, one. Okay. And now the next one is gonna be the more advanced one. We're gonna do a little jump and we're gonna cross the leg behind the other leg. So Manona's gonna show. Go down into skating position, she jumps away. And every time when you land on your leg, you bring your other leg and your other foot behind. So the hard work is done, but it's not finished yet. So we're gonna do some cooling down. We'll do some dynamic stretching and then we can call it a day. First one, grab your knee, pull it towards you and just small movements. You don't have to pull hard. Small movements back and forth, 10 times and then you get the other leg. 10 times, forward. Open your hips, because everything got tight while jumping. So now we make everything loose. The other one again, and you can try to make small circles. Forward, backward. Move those hips. And you can steer with your hands. Keep your hips flat on the mat or on the ground. And then switch legs again. Little circles backwards, you can make the number 8. And feel where it's tight. And if you feel a tight spot, you go in there. So you move a little bit towards that spot. Try to open it up. Okay. Next one. Grab your ankle. Don't grab your foot, grab your ankle. And pull towards you. Hold it for a couple seconds and release. Hold it and release. And with your elbow, you can push your knee out. So again, open up those hips. You switch foot, you switch legs, grab your ankle, use your elbow, push your knee to the outside, and you'll probably feel some stretching on the outside of your hip. And switch again. Stay dynamic and switch again. Stay dynamic. Okay, next one. I'm gonna lie on your side. Grab your ankle again. Stay on your elbow. And the same thing. Move backwards. You probably feel it stretching. Keep it dynamic, make some circles, and again, feel where it's tight. Stretch a little bit more. But always keep it dynamic. Don't pull too hard. And switch sides. On your elbow, grab your ankle. Open up those hips. Keep the upper body in one line. Okay. And sit down. I hope you liked the training. We definitely had a great time. What about you, Manon?
Yes, it was great, and it was a very good training. I think so, and I think tomorrow you also feel it that you trained today.
Yeah, exactly. And we definitely look tomorrow again at our YouTube channel, because tomorrow it's going to be the Center of Excellence in Beijing, and it's going to be a very interesting training. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, again, use the chat on YouTube. And maybe till next time. Thank you.
Okay. Bye bye, guys.
Thank you for the training.
Bye. Thanks for the session. It was a lot of fun.
Thanks for the awesome training. See you next time.